Hi, I'm Joel from TYBA, and I will be presenting an interfaith prayer. The pandemic has seeped into all our lives, affected us in different ways, taken a little from some and a lot from others. Only one thing is certain, we all need some reassurance and hope in these unprecedented and uncertain times. Now, more than ever before, we must come together as fellow human beings, as part of nature and the cosmos that binds us together, to pray. Let us now read a few words from our scriptures that will provide us with the much needed hope and strength. To begin, a verse from the Bhagavad Gita. Shri Krishna said to Arjuna, "When righteousness is weak and faint, and unrighteousness exults in pride, then my spirit arises on earth for the salvation of those who are good and for the destruction of evil in human beings. For the fulfillment of the kingdom of righteousness, I come to this world in ages that pass." Reading from the Gita, chapter 4, verse 7 to 8. Despite the grimness of our times, righteousness in our minds and hearts is what really matters. Let us pray that we remember to be just and good in our actions. Let us put our hope in the path of fairness and compassion. Now, for a reading from the Quran. Those who believe and whose heart find satisfaction in the remembrance of God. For without doubt, in the righteousness and the remembrance of God, do hearts find satisfaction. For those who believe and work, righteousness is blessedness and a beautiful place to return. Reading from the Quran, chapter 13, verse 28 to 29. The path of righteousness today is filled with people putting themselves at risk to provide relief for others. Let us pray for their health and well-being. Let us learn from their compassion and be grateful for the hope that they bring. Now, a reading from the Bible. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but rather on what is unseen. Since what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 18. May our current situation help us to go beyond the apparent and look at what lies underneath. May we look at darkness and disease and see strength. May we look at our struggles and see more compassion. May we look at the healing environment and see renewal. May we look at the oppression of others and see the need for change. Now, a lesson from the Buddha. As I am, so are these. As are these, so am I. Drawing the parallel to yourself, neither kill nor get others to kill. A reading from the Nalaka Sutra. Let us pray for our particularly vulnerable brothers and sisters and stand in solidarity with them. The Guru Granth Sahib says, "I am a stranger to no one, and no one is a stranger to me. Indeed, I am a friend to all." Let us pray for our leaders and government officials, that they might act with wisdom and empathy, and that they might include all within the boundaries of their care. Finally, to quote the Jain scripture, "One should treat all creatures in the world as one would like to be treated." A verse from the Sutra Kritanga. Let us pray for the safety and rejuvenation, not only the people, but also the plants, the trees, the animals, and all beings that inhabit our cosmos. In light of the scriptures we have just read, let us pray for peace among all people and all nature, for solidarity, compassion, and strength, and for good health and healing, which is mental, physical, and emotional.
Dear friends, wish you a warm welcome to St. Xavier's College. I am Father Keith D'Souza and I am the rector of the college. We are, all of us, in a moment of history which may be defined as the Great Pause. This has affected the whole human family. We are at a crisis moment. It's an opportunity for change. I invite you to respond to three mandates which may be associated with this crisis moment. First mandate is a professional mandate. And that mandate is be creative. What does be creative mean? Put negatively, be creative means don't blindly imitate. The second mandate is at a personal level. And the mandate there is be authentic. Be authentic. The first aspect of authenticity is to be an integrated person. The second aspect of authenticity is to communicate the truth. The third aspect of this personal mandate to be authentic is to minimize your wants. Finally, the last mandate, which is an important mandate, that is to be respectful. That's at the level of society. Respect the dignity of the other. Secondly, respect the dignity of different communities. And the third would be to respect the earth. So I wish you a happy and joyful experience at Xavier's. And I invite you and challenge you at the same time to respond to these three mandates. At the professional level, to be creative. At the personal level, to be authentic. And at the social level, to be respectful. Enjoy your life at Xavier's.
Very good morning to all students, parents, and faculty members who are present here today. Welcome to this 151 years old iconic institution, the St. Xavier's College. We are meeting in a virtual and new normal situation mode. Usually, we would have had this orientation program in our Heritage Hall. However, the present COVID circumstances do not allow us to meet in person. Nevertheless, let me begin by congratulating each one of you and your parents. I would like to acknowledge the students for working very hard and earning your seat in our college, and your parents for their unstinting support and encouragement to help you realize your dream. It is said, if you have the power to dream, you also have the power to make it come true. Our college stands among the top 100 in National Institutional Ranking Framework for the year 1920. The survey done by Education World magazine puts us at the top, the first in India, amongst the private autonomous colleges for the year 1920. The just released The Week magazine survey has placed our arts section 8th in India and 1st in Mumbai, and science section 12th in India and 1st in Mumbai. We have secured an A grade in the third cycle of NAC accreditation system and will be going in for the fourth cycle coming October 2020. We have been allotted grants by various granting agencies. For example, DBT, Department of Biotechnology, RUSA, Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan, all of which attest to our standard of academic excellence. Recently, we have been awarded the DBT Builder Program by the DBT worth 3 crores of grant for our science laboratory infrastructures. The College of Excellence Award by UGC 2014, Nipman Foundation Microsoft Equal Opportunity Award in 2018, in the enabler category of inclusive school and higher education. Certificate of Excellence Award in 2014 by ASSOCHAM for the best institute serving a social cause are few accolades to mention here. You are now part of the legacy of an institution that has been consistently giving high quality education for 151 years. You are also a part of a history where alumna or alumni like Advocate Soli Surabji, Dr. Homi Sechna, industrialists like Adi Godrej, Azim Premji, Anu Aga and Dr. Swati Piramal, cricketers like Sunil Gavaskar, Polly Umbrigger, actresses like Shabana Azmi, Vidya Balan and many, many more have left their mark in the corridors of the college as well as in the society. The torch is now handed over to you to carry this legacy forward. Your responsibility has increased manifold. With the support of academic autonomy since 2010, we have been able to design our courses, learning experiences, and evaluation to be more relevant, interdisciplinary and innovative, challenging our students to work and earn their degrees, credits and honor certificates while simultaneously honing their soft skills, coping strategies and creating potentials. All of this is being achieved within the value-based framework of an Ignatian pedagogical paradigm of our key values, innovation, integration, and inclusion. It's a crucial element being understanding the context of the learner providing relevant and creative teaching learning experiences, getting the students to reflect in their learning, and motivating them into action to apply their learnings and make the world a better place. Our evaluation system, that is Continuous Internal Assessment, popularly known as CIA, and ESE or End Semester Exams, are designed to assess different levels of learning objectives and skills that are relevant to the course content and potential employers in the professional realms. Another Ignatian pedagogical principle, MAGIS, means more, means doing more for others, achieving more excellence. As Xavier writes, you are expected to go beyond in academics as well as in the social sphere. We have a whole team of teaching and non-teaching staff that are committed to helping you actualize your potential. Our teachers don't just cover the syllabus, they uncover it for you to discover. Although we are proud of our heritage structure, the vibrant essence of this college comes from its staff, students, parents, alumni, and well-wishers. All our activities, both in and out of classrooms, are designed to help students to gain knowledge in their chosen discipline, to develop confidence in themselves and show compassion for others less fortunate than themselves. Our minimum 75% attendance policy is enforced because we believe that the interaction and learning experiences in the classroom can help students to process the information, respect diverse viewpoints, and contribute to the construction of new knowledge. Information is available at your fingertips, often at the click of the mouse or the swipe of a screen. But how much of this information is relevant, whether it is credible, and how it can be applied? These questions require critical thinking and experience. The experience of visiting a slum is different from reading about it. When the heart is touched, the mind is forced to change. Working on a group project with classmates who are differently abled is vital to developing an attitude of inclusion. Exchanging ideas with those who have come from different parts of the country or the world is a stepping stone for students who then learn to appreciate diversity and challenge stereotypes. Researching and presenting at an honors program seminars in Khandala is different from submitting a written assignment or answering an exam paper. By the way, every official trip requires parents' or guardians' consent on the duly signed form sent to you by the college authorities. These are just some of the learning opportunities that are integrated in St. Xavier's, which, as the line on the t-shirt says, is not just a college, but it's a way of life. Due to lockdown and COVID, you may not be doing these activities which I just mentioned, but I'm positive that you will all would be coming on campus soon and then experiencing what I said. If that does not happen soon, then you have an opportunity to be more creative and find the ways to learn as much as possible. So let's be positive about it. So in our brand education that you have chosen to be a part of, you students need to be responsible for your punctuality, attentiveness, attendance, and performance, and accountable for your choices and behavior. Performance comprises both continuous internal assessment and end semester exams and you need to attend a minimum of 40% to clear each course. Similarly, you need to have 75% attendance in each course. We actually expect you to give 100% attendance, but are giving a leeway of 25% for participation in relevant activities beyond the campus, as well as for the medical reasons. Attendance can be monitored each month online, and warnings are given as well. But please note that if you fall below the required level, you will not be allowed to appear for the end semester exams. You will then be given a chance to attempt an additional exam 6 months later. Many of you are joining us with very high percentage, very high academic scores. You have to continue to work hard in your first year and second year in order to earn a respectable GPA and to be granted a major subject of your choice when you reach TY. Our college is known for various innovative programs such as Mallar, Honors Program and Social Involvement Program, just a few to mention here. Through our Social Involvement Program, we would like to sensitize our students towards their social responsibilities. The college just doesn't teach you to be socially responsible, but also practices. During this lockdown period, the college campus was given to Bombay Municipal Corporation to use it as quarantine center. We also distributed food and medical kits to the migrants, patients, police and medical workers worth 7 lakhs rupees. The future seems distant, but time flies once you are in Xavier's. We have a vision for the future of our college that may someday be given degree granting status. We have designed and begun unaided postgraduate courses that we believe will help our students become professionally competent and will help the community at large. It is also my moral duty to remind you that the cost of maintaining this quality of educational experience is far higher than the nominal fees that are paid by you. Just for your information, the cost of one BA or a BSc lecture is approximately 65 paise. But the maintenance and upgradation of infrastructure and facilities in a heritage building such as ours is a monumental task by itself. So let us not take it for granted. Let us consider ourselves joint stakeholders in the quest of academic excellence, leadership, and social responsibility. I sincerely appeal to each one of us, students, parents, and alumni, to find a way to contribute towards taking this legacy of Xavier's forward into the next 100 years. And you can do it. Some of you might be scientists, some of you might be experts in various fields. Nowadays, you can talk to our students. If you want to give a webinar, please contact me and you can contribute in teaching too, not just monetarily. And my dear students, I would suggest the last, work conscientiously, participate in activities, and enjoy your years in Xavier's, such that we can all hold our heads high and say to the universe, we are made of Xavier's. Thank you.
A very good morning and a warm welcome to each one of you. Congratulations, students. You are now a part of our prestigious institute. I'm Dr. Annapurna, Vice Principal Arts, and from the Department of Statistics. I promise you, students, that your journey at Xavier's will be an enriching and learning experience. It will help you to not only be successful in your profession, but also it will mold you into better human beings. Today, I shall be discussing academic matters specific to the arts and also some very important general instructions for all the first years. Had it not been for the pandemic, today we would all be interacting on this orientation program day in this stately, iconic heritage building called Xavier's. But it is just a matter of time. Very soon, we will all be back to the place where we belong, and that is Xavier's. Students, you are quite well versed with these three groups because you have chosen a subject from each of these groups to form your three core subjects. At the first year, you will have one course per subject per semester. You will have to learn two languages, of which one is effective English skills. The other language can be an option between French and Hindi. Students with learning disabilities can opt for library science. There is a special course for every semester in the first 2 years. Thus, when we move on to the second year, we have 8 courses. The three core subjects have 2 courses per subject per semester. In semester 3, you have human rights as a special course. A unique aspect of Xavier's is it helps every student to develop holistically. In the 4th semester, the special course is called cross-faculty course. As the name suggests, every student from the arts faculty will learn one course from the various courses, which are very interesting also, that are offered by the departments of the sciences. Some of these courses I have listed on the screen. Then there is one more course called as the applied component. Thus, the total courses at the second year are 8 in number. Finally, when you reach TY, you will specialize with 6 courses. Either you will decide to be a single subject major, that is, you will be a student of a single department, or you might decide to do part majors, that is, you will take 2 subjects and major partially in each of them. There are certain departments like Hindi, French, statistics, anthropology, and commerce that do not have single majors at TYs. Now, how do we select our part majors? Part majors at the 3rd year is decided by the college based on various parameters such as student strength, workload of the department, infrastructure limitations, etc. Hence, it is a decision that is revised every year and does not depend on the previous year's offering of part majors. The choice of subject majors at TY. This process begins at the end of semester 4 when you are asked to list your preferences by the college office. The college, in consultation with the departments, will decide on which subject can be allotted to each student. It is solely based on merit. That is, your subject marks in the past semesters are considered, and also it is based on the availability of seats in that department. Hence, students, it is very important that you work towards your goal in a very consistent manner every semester. So at the end of 3 years, you collect a total of 150 credits, of which 146 credits are academic in nature. There are 4 non-academic mandatory credits, of which 2 are gathered from a program very dear to the college and very unique to this college, called as the Social Involvement Program. This program aims at making education socially relevant and meaningful. The motto being, when the heart is touched by direct experience, the mind is challenged to change. Extracurricular credits, again two in count. Here, the college gives a platform to every student to participate in the various cultural and extracurricular activities on campus and outside campus, thus encouraging students to explore their hidden talents. So at the end of 3 years, your academic bank is richer by 150 credits. Only then do you graduate from this college. Coming back to our first year, there are many divisions that you need to remember. The timetable will also give you an understanding. So the subject of economics has two divisions, A and B. Similarly, sociology has two divisions, A and B. Since every student at the first year has to go through the special course, there are three divisions in which all of you are accommodated, A, B, and C. A student who is in Division A for the special course will also remain in Division A of EES and will stay with Division AT, that is Division A tutorial batch or for EES tutorials. Similarly, a student who is in Division C of special course will naturally be in the Division C of EES and CT of EES tutorial. Here, I want you to be very clear. Divisions A and B in this group of special course and EES has no connection to the divisions A and B of economics and sociology. Further, there is French compulsory and Hindi compulsory. There are two divisions, AB and BC. Each of you will be given your respective divisions by Ms. Delina from the general office very soon. Now, how do we look at the timetable and decode the timetable? If you observe, your lectures commence at 8 in the morning. They are of 50-minute duration with a 10-minute break. So you have lectures from 8 to 8.50, 9 to 9.50, 10 to 10.50, and so on. Your lunch break is at 11.50 up to 12.30, after which, again, lectures will continue. The 10-minute gap between two lectures has been specially introduced because of the online mode of teaching. This is to help you log out and log in to the next class with ease. It also helps you to reduce the strain to your eyes by continuous watching of the screen. So use it to your advantage. Take a quick break and be on time for the next class. Now let's look at this small area which I have marked to understand the timetable in a more better way. So this is the timetable subpart. I have to the right a list of teachers who teach the first year BA, their names, the subjects they teach, the divisions they teach, and also the initials as displayed on the timetable. So if I go to Wednesday, that is tomorrow, when you would start class, your first day at Xavier's, the first lecture is economics for the B divisions. So they will be taught by a professor with the initials APS. So I'll go directly into this table and I see APS as Dr. Aditi Savant, who is also the head of the economics department. If I move on to the 9 o'clock lecture, there is a stats lecture, statistics, taught by none other than me. Then there is anthropology, taught by Miss Professor Radhika Rani. We have French, taught by Professor Alpana Palkiwala. And this is how you learn and understand how to navigate through your timetable. It's not difficult. It just takes a little bit of understanding. Some of y'all had asked for some changes of subject, and so the college decided to put up a notice on the college website for students to apply for whatever subject they wished to obtain. So the last date for filling this form was 21st August. All subject changes will be given by merit, provided they are available. The change will be informed to the student by email. Please note, we will not be able to display the list on the website. The last date for any change to be sent from the college office to the student is 31st of this month. After that, there will be no change of subjects at all. Now, you all have an option between French and Hindi as one of your languages. Please attend the first 2-3 days, and in case you wish to have a change, you may write a mail to Miss Delina at delina.lopez@xaviers.edu. Miss Delina is the in charge person at the general office for all matters dealing with the first years. Your email for this change must reach us before the 31st of August, and provided we have a seat available, we will help you. For students who have secured admission to the Bachelor's of Management Studies and the BA Mass Communication and Journalism, you have currently nothing to worry about what I have been speaking so long about. Subject changes, subject choices, progression from first year to second year, because all your courses are compulsive. It's a natural progression for you. There is no subject choice, hence no change of subject. The electives come into place only in the TY. Your departments are displayed here. BMS department is headed by Ms. Soni George and supported by Dr. Neelam Shetty and Mr. Pritesh Arte. The BA MCJ course is headed by Ms. Perya Nayake and supported by Ms. Akshara Jadhav. Your teachers will individually explain their timetable and the various other rules that govern these two courses. Both these departments invite professionals from the industry so that they can share their real-world knowledge and expertise with all of you. However, please do remember, in order to graduate from Xavier's, you also must collect a total of 150 credits, of which 146 are academic and 2 credits from social involvement program and 2 credits from the extracurricular activities you will participate in. Now let's look at how we join the online classes from tomorrow. Since we are conducting classes in the virtual world, in order to help you ease into this new mode of learning, you will receive an invite to the Google Classroom created for every course. The learning platforms that are used to conduct online classes will be either Zoom or Google Meet. The title of each class has been created in a very specific and structured manner for your convenience. It starts with the class you're in, followed by the faculty you're in, then subject. The subject may have more than one course, and hence this is a course code. And finally, the teacher who will be teaching. So this is the title that will be displayed as the title of the Google Classroom. Your teachers will send you this title as well as your class code, which will help you easily join into the classes. Parents, it's all about teamwork. Your collaboration is a very, very important component to make this teaching learning experience a successful endeavor, not only for your children, but also for us teachers. Hence, I request each one of you to read the college handbook and understand the rules that govern the college. Please attend the annual parent-teachers meeting. I hope this year we meet face-to-face. Please do check the attendance as well as the performance of our students, because we display them on website and you have access to it. Ask for updates about their performance, because every assessment after the results are created, the students are shown the papers or the results now will be discussed with them. Of course, with prior appointment, you're welcome to meet us once we start classroom teaching and we all come back into Xavier's. Students, it's also your responsibility that you every day check the Xavier's EDU email that has been created specially for each one of you. Also, it's very important that you look up the college website where all important notices for you will be displayed, be it from the principal's desk, be it from the exam center, be it from the office, or any other very important aspect would be put up on the college website only. Students must also read the college handbook and familiarize themselves with the workings and the various facilities that are available in the college. The email IDs where you can contact us are listed here. I now hand over the proceedings to the Vice Principal Science, Dr. Rishikesh Raman, who will talk about certain specific matters dealing with the sciences and then move on to very important general instructions for all first-year students. But before I leave, I share with you a few lines from this poem, Where the Mind is Without Fear, by Rabindranath Tagore. This is how I envisage every Xavierite to be when he or she graduates from this college and is challenged to fly and soar to greater heights of success. Thank you. And with this, I end my presentation. Thank you for your patient hearing. And students, I wish you all the best for a very wonderful 3 years of enriching experiences at Xavier's. Thank you.
Thank you, Annapurna. Hello, students and parents. I'm Rishikesh Samant, Vice Principal Science, and also an Associate Professor in the Department of Geology at St. Xavier's. You have already heard the details related to the art subjects and also some common to all regulations. I will now add essential matters which are also common to all and some which are specific to the sciences. As you already might be knowing, this is our famous first quad of St. Xavier's College. This is where you would have been interviewed and later on be having this orientation on your very first day of college. Due to changed circumstances, we are all meeting online. The essentials you really need to know. Let's begin with a brief walk on the sands of time. I'll be telling you something more about your college, add on to what Professor Annapurna has already told you, but more specifically about the sciences, the academic progression of science students, the divisions which are specific to science students, and most importantly, understanding your daily schedule, that is understanding how you will read your timetable, your academic credits, and of course, the most important is discipline matters and attendance. Let me tell you something about your college. The first Jesuit institute in India was established in 1549. That's where the real history of our college begins. The Jesuits established this in the Vasai Fort, which today remains as just a crumbled structure within the fort. And that's where our old college was constructed. It was not called St. Xavier's, of course, but it was the first Jesuit college in India. The link to that college and ours is seen in form of the rhyolite stone, which was quarried and from which that old college was made. For those who would be visiting our chapel when you join the college, the altar stone of the chapel of St. Xavier's is from the same rock which the first Jesuit institute in India was built more than 470 years ago. Having shared with you this beautiful piece of history, let's start with the business at hand, your subject combinations. As all of you would know, St. Xavier's for the science stream offers 11 different combinations in the first year. All of you science students would have been admitted to one of these 11, which you see listed out here. The combinations are known by their abbreviations and the combination numbers. For example, combination 8 is geology, chemistry, and physics. Combination 11 is maths, statistics, and economics. We now come to the divisions you have been allocated. You can see them listed based on the combinations. A word of caution here, you need to understand that the divisions which you are in are also linked with the specific subjects you have been offered. But a student who has physics and geology, which you see in, as an example over here, combination 7 is chemistry, physics, maths, while combination 8 is geology, chemistry, physics. You see physics offered over here, that student will be in division B. And at the same time, he would also be in division BC for attending chemistry. The information which you see over here would also be available to you through the emails which are being sent to you. You would have other divisions for your special courses. Your special course would be environmental studies. Let me come to now your progression in the next 3 years. All science students take 3 subjects in the first year. In the second year, one of the subjects is dropped. I would give you an example of the geology, chemistry, physics combination here. This combination can lead to you majoring in second year with geology and chemistry, or you could take geology and physics, or you could also take chemistry and physics. Do note the choice or admission to a specific subject at the SYBSC level and subsequently at the TY, that's your final year, is dependent on availability of seats and of course on your merit in the preceding years. I would like to caution you, a course backlog, which would be rather unfortunate, may deprive you of your choice subject or seat in TY. So dear students, I urge you to start working hard from day one. That brings me to telling you something about your daily schedule in college. Do note, this schedule is specifically for the present situation. The schedule is only for the online lectures and practicals with which we will start from tomorrow. This rather detailed and intricate chart which you see over here is made available to you on the college website. It is not really as complicated. I draw your attention to the first day you would be attending lectures, that is Wednesday. And look at the times you have. The college begins at 8 o'clock. So your first lecture starts at 8 and continues till 8:50. And as you have already been told by Professor Annapurna, there are 10-minute breaks between every lecture. Please do utilize these breaks for resting your eyes. We have a lunch break between 11:50 and 12:30. And after this, all science students would have their lab or practical sessions, which are also online. Some more details about how you read the timetable. I draw your attention to Wednesday, the 9 to 9:50 slot. Your lectures at the 9 to 9:50 slot, for example, those who are in Division A have physics, and the timetable also lists the teacher who would be teaching you. You have Professor Radhakrishna Dubey, who will be teaching physics for Division A. Simultaneously, those who have geology as one of their subject would have the lecture for geology taken by Professor Shweta Gurav. I hope this is clear. Please do download the timetable from the college website. That brings me to telling you about the credits which you would be completing this year. There is no difference between the number of credits which an arts graduate and a science graduate needs to complete before getting the bachelor's degree in hand. As you see, we have a total of 150 credits that you would need to graduate from our college. We also offer some very interesting subjects which makes our college rather different and special. In your second year, fourth semester, you have the cross-faculty courses. These are a specialty of St. Xavier's. Science students are offered, or rather are mandated to take courses or choose a course offered by the Arts, Management Studies, or the Media Studies departments. I have listed a few such beautiful courses out here. You can take up courses in Gandhian Studies, Indian Constitution, so and so forth. Do note, these courses are also part of your credits. We also have four non-academic but mandatory credits. These have been already explained to you by Vice Principal Arch, Professor Annapurna. I would just like to stress that these are also mandatory. This was discussed by Professor Annapurna. I add on to it, many of you have been requesting a change in your present subject combination. Well, there was a link available to you on the college website. Many, many of you have applied. But do note that just application for the subject change does not mean you will get it. Change in combination is granted as per merit and, of course, subject to availability. You all know that the last date to submit your application was Friday, the 21st of August. If you have been offered a change of combination, you will receive an email confirming the same by the 31st of August, after which you would need to start attending the lectures in the changed combination. Till now, whatever I said was specific only to the BSc stream. We also have with us BSc in Information Technology. Students who have taken admission in this course do not have any change in subject. They do not need to apply for anything. They have all courses compulsory. There are no electives. However, if you have any queries, please do feel free to contact the department faculty, which I have listed here. The IT department coordinator is Professor Roy Thomas, and you have the other teachers that are Subhash Kumar, Professor Lydia, and Professor Rachana. What I will be continuing from now is common even to you IT students. Discipline. Let's realize that we are all interacting now during lectures as well as practicals in an online fashion. This will continue till the authorities permit the college to open for physical attendance. All students are expected to follow the policy of netiquette for online education listed on the college website. I request you all, students as well as parents, to please read this document on the college website. The list and the link is given down below. That brings me to an extremely important matter, that is your attendance. Though lectures and practicals are online, St. Xavier's continues to insist that you would need 75% attendance in lectures and practicals in each course in each semester. Do note, my dear students of science, certification of practical journals is mandatory in order for you to be eligible to appear for the practical exams. So please do not miss your practicals. I would like to stress again over here, those below 75% at the end of the term may not be allowed to appear for the semester end exam. I hope none of you fall in this trap. Record of absence. Some of us, due to some unfortunate reason, may need to stay absent, may not be able to attend lectures or practicals, though they are online. Well, there is a way to inform the college and ask for leave of absence. Do note, this leave is within the balance of 25% and will not be considered as part of the 75% mandatory attendance required. We at St. Xavier's encourage you to attend 100% of your lectures. The link to record your absence and the reasons would be made available to you on the college website. To tell you how important your attendance is and how we at St. Xavier's take it very, very seriously, your attendance also appears as an attendance grade on your semester end grade card. So it wouldn't be good to see a C or a D attendance grade on your semester grade card. So dear students, please keep up your attendance as much as possible. 100% attendance is always welcome. I have already said this, your lectures and practicals are going to be presently online. Professor Annapurna has already told you and given you some details about how they will be held. We are conducting the lectures using the Zoom or the Google Meet interface. You will also have the Google Classroom or other learning management system where educational material, notes, the presentations would be made available to you for download. Invitation to attend these lectures and labs will be sent by the respective course instructors. So it is important that you keep checking your email regularly. That brings me to the daily pit stops. If you were in college, and you soon will be, you would be checking the notice boards, the physical notice boards, or even the digital ones, which display notices and information all across the college. But in this semester, or in the weeks to come, you would be totally relying on the college website, which will inform you about the various exam schedules, the university ordinances, information about international programs, scholarships, deadlines to various programs, opportunities, events. Everything is available on the St. Xavier's College website at www.xaviers.edu. And of course, the most important is your own personal xaviers.edu.in email ID. Students, feel proud. You will have this email for the rest of your life. You can continue using this always. So please do make use of it. And please do check this email ID multiple times a day, because you will be receiving your lecture invites and other information on this email. St. Xavier's always looks forward to collaboration between parents and teachers. Professor Annapurna has already told you that we do conduct annual parent-teacher meetings. I just hope and pray that this year's annual parent-teacher meeting happens in a way we always have had it, in that beautiful college hall. The parents can also check the attendance and performance of their wards on the college website. You could also ask for details of all exam papers as they are shown to your wards. And last but not the least, all you parents are welcome to meet us or contact us with prior appointment. At St. Xavier's, we stand for academic excellence, social justice, equality of opportunity, care for environment, and respect for religious and moral values. Dear students, this is a glimpse of where you will be 3 years from today, graduating as proud Xavierites. St. Xavier's, it's not just a college, it's a way of life. We look forward to meeting all of you in college soon. I now hand over the presentation to Professor Marzban Kotwal, our Controller of Examination and the Head of the Department of Chemistry. Thank you.
Thank you for the introduction, Dr. Samant. A very good morning and a warm welcome to one and all attending the online orientation program for the first year students. The facade of the building that you are seeing on the screen out here on the first floor holds the chapel of the college. And strategically placed to the right of it out here is the exam center of the college. The exam center of the college is responsible for planning, scheduling, and conducting the exams and ensuring quality mechanisms through fair evaluation and timely declaration of results. For all theory courses, there are two comprehensive assessments or evaluations, a formative one in the form of internal assessment and a summative one in the form of end semester exams, with the marks distribution weightage being 40:60. The internal assessment, popularly known as CIAs, are broken into two parts. CIA 1, which is generally a written or a sit-down test, and CIA 2, which has more creative modalities like assignments, MCQs, seminar presentations, field trips, model making, writing critique, so on and so forth. The end semester exams are of 2 hours duration for most of the courses, though some courses are exception. Similarly, for practicals, many departments conduct CIAs and end semester exams. All departments hold an autonomy to devise their own modalities, and 10% of the marks are reserved for the journals. However, journal is certified only if a minimum of 75% attendance is clocked by a student. As a quality mechanism, and for seeking external validation, the end semester exam papers of first year and second year students are moderated, and the TY courses, there is a double blind evaluation. To pass a course, a student has to secure a minimum of 40 marks out of 100. That is 40% is the minimum marks for passing in a given course. This includes the CIA marks. If a student does not manage to secure 40 marks, the student will need to reattempt the course exam as a 100 marks additional exam the following semester. So this 100 mark paper is a 3-hour paper. Similarly, for practical course, 40 marks or 40% of the marks are passing, failing which a student can attempt additional exams, not in the next semester, but in the following academic year in the corresponding semester. If a student has a backlog of more than 12 credits, the student is not promoted to the next higher class. However, students with less than 12 credit backlog, though promoted, are advised to clear their additional exams at the earliest. Also, at this point, I would like to caution you against using any unfair means or plagiarizing assignments, as the college has a strict stand against such misdemeanors from the students. A maximum of 1% of the total marks are awarded to pass the exam as grace marks. A maximum of 1% of grace marks are awarded only at the end of 6 semester exams to improve the class, provided a student has never availed the grace marks earlier. Mark sheets are issued for each exam, including additional exams, and contains grades and grade points on a 10-point scale. At the end of 6 semesters, a consolidated mark sheet is given for all 6 semesters, provided the student has cleared all the courses and has no courses pending. Here is the table mentioning the mark intervals and the corresponding grades as well as the grade points. Students with disabilities, depending on their challenges, are given certain concessions and accommodation letters are given to them stating the same. Students having the accommodation letters are required to attach the photocopy of the letters to their papers for every exam that they attempt. Let me take this opportunity to point out that college strives hard to influence the cognitive domain, the psychomotor domain, and the affective domain in a positive manner to promote the growth of the students. The exam papers are designed on the basis of Bloom's taxonomy to induce higher order thinking skills among students and hence are challenging in nature. Ultimately, the aim of any education should be to ignite the minds. Till we meet for face-to-face lectures, you can contact the examination center for any exam-related problems, issues, or queries at the email ID given out here, examination.center@xaviers.edu. Also, you will receive an email from the teachers asking you to join the LMS like Google Classroom, where the teachers can communicate with you. So you will receive this email on your xaviers.edu.in email ID, which has been sent to you through an email. Thank you.